Hi everyone, Saeed here. Today I have a special guest. She is so lovely. Look what I have found under the engine of my car. You know, it's freezing outside and full of snow. And I looked for her mom, I couldn't find her. So I think she's gonna stay with me. What do you think? Okay, let's talk about today's video. Today I'm going to show you how to design these animated slides in PowerPoint. So let's design it together. Let's start by drawing a rectangle and drag it to this side. Hold the Ctrl and Shift keys down and make three copies exactly beside each other. Select all of them, then press Ctrl G to group them. Since we have grouped them, we can easily adjust them without distorting the aspect ratio. Now we can ungroup them. Make sure all the shapes are selected, then right-click on them and select Format Object. In this window, add a drop shadow in this direction to them. Set the blur amount to 25 and distance to 12. Let's remove their outline, then change each shape's color. These are the color codes that I used, but if you don't know how to use the color code, click on the shape fill icon and select more fill colors from the menu. In this window, select Custom tab and enter your code here. Then click on OK. Anyway, let's add a rounded rectangle to this slide. Change its height and width to 1. Put it in this position, then hold the Ctrl key down and make 3 copies like this. Select all of them and choose Distribute Vertically from the Align menu. Let me change their color as well. Now we have to merge each shape with its relative shape. First, select this shape, then the small one. Go to the Shape Format tab and click on the Merge Shape icon. Then select the Union from the menu. Remember, don't select this shape first, then the big one. Because when you choose Union, the formatting of the first selected shape will apply to the next one. So always, first select the shape that you want to keep its formatting. Okay, repeat this for the other parts. Now I am going to add the information of the D section. Click on this icon and add a new text box. Type in the D letter and change its font size and style. In this case, I have used the Objective Black font style. Let's change its color and align it to the center as well. Now I am going to add a drop shadow to the letter. Select the Text Option tab and add a drop shadow in this direction to it. Set the blur amount to 25 and distance to 12. Add the title and details to the slide as well. Go to the Insert tab and click on the Icon tool. In this window, select your suitable icon, then insert it. Change its color to white. Now hold the Ctrl key down and select these four items, then align them to the center. Again, hold the Ctrl key down and select this shape. Then by pressing Ctrl G, group them. You might ask, why did I start from the D section? Because when I grouped it, the layer of group moved to the top. So if I add the C section's information and group it with its shape, it will be moved to the top as well. Which means at the end, the order of all the layers will be correct.
I hope you liked this video so far. If you did, please like and subscribe to the channel and ring the notification bell for additional upcoming videos. Alright, let's get back to the video.
Now duplicate this slide, then in the first slide, Hold the shift key down and arrange each shape like this. Press Ctrl A to select all of them and drag them to this side. Also, select Distribute Horizontally from the Align menu. The background is so solid. Let's fill it with a video. Okay, first align it to the middle and center. Then send it back. Perfect. You can download this video in the description. Anyway, I think the blue color of video is a little saturated. So go to the Video Format tab and in the Color section, select this color. It's better. Since we want it to start automatically, go to the Playback tab and select Start Automatically from the menu. Also, check Loop until stopped. Let me show you the slide in full screen mode. Alright, let's add a new text box to the slide. For those of you who are wondering what kind of text effect is this, I have explained how to design it in this video. So if you haven't watched it, I will put the link in the description. Now I'm going to add the other words. Let's adjust them like this. It looks good, but I want to add a drop shadow to them to give them a 3D look. But before that, we have to make sure that the order of all the layers is correct. So we have to activate the selection pane. First, I'm going to change their names. This one is 4. 4 should be at top. Drag its layer to the top. This one is chapter. Project in. Alright, the order of all the layers is correct. For example, in is under chapter, above project. Anyway, select all the words, then right click on them and select Format Object. In this window, add a drop shadow in this direction to them. Set 20 for the transparency. Blur 55 and distance 40. Now select all the words and by pressing Ctrl G group them. Hold the Ctrl key down and select the text group and the video. Then copy and paste them into the next slide. First, drag the text group to the outside, then send the video to the back. Can you tell me why we copied them in this slide? Because we want to use the morph transition, so we need them in both slides. Now we have to design the third slide. Right click on the first slide and duplicate it. Then drag it down. Delete the text group and drag all the cards to the outside. Let me copy the A letter and paste it here. And increase its size a little bit. Also, align it to the center. Now I'm going to add this section's title, which is Introduction. The A letter is so solid, let's add an inner shadow to the text. Change its color and increase the blur amount to 50. Since we want to use the morph transition, we have to copy and paste them into the previous slide. Also, drag them to the outside. If you want, you can increase their font size a little bit. By increasing the font size, they will look better during the transition. Now everything is ready. Hold the Ctrl key down and select these two slides in the ribbon. Now add the morph transition to them. Your PowerPoint is ready. Let's check it out.